but there's a limit to how aggressive he can be in the lane. And Abaddon is, like I said, with the axe, you know, one of those heroes.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Combatants down! It begins.
The first thread is cut!
Well, this axe trying to build defense in the bottom lane, trying to feed his heart as much as possible, but once that swarm got shot out into his face, he was pretty much already using items that even laning against the Weaver is going to be fine. He doesn't have to feel afraid of him too much, but obviously running right head into him is maybe going to be a little bit trouble for me, as he has got himself away from that. But a lot of times the Weaver wants to get a little bit closer to him, he's going to be healed up with that Shadow Word from RR, keeping him safe, but the Weaver is going to go for that. The Barcrack number 2 comes out as the Yoga Manager will be taken down first. The Warlock takes a cross back to the face as well. Weaver, he's not done yet, he still has the time lapse available, so if he sees the Warlock, he will go for the kill. And they get to go for the next Tsukuchi. They stun up, they get onto the animate again, the Frostbite comes out as well. Gabby is trying to kill on him, will get the kill on him. They find us. Well, this is looking bad, as that's going to be a triple kill to Gabby on that Weaver. Jesse Vash comes in for round 2. He might still be in trouble. Will they still have more mana left on that Weaver? He's going to be a little bit careful, but he will get that time knocked off in time. It looks like Tracy will die, but they get an ultra kill first. They share the giving space for that Antimage, which he desperately needs, and they'll see they go in. Gonna try to go for the tank to find him in the creep wave, and that should be an easy kill as he gets stunned up, he gets controlled. They do have the dunk available as well, but despite that, you know, they're both just waiting for that. And Jack tries to go for TV back home, surviving, but no, Gabi will be able to find that kill on him. Gabi maybe gets another kill here. Jesse Vash is going to take a lot of damage. Fire Blast comes out, but Gabi, he's not going to back up at all. He's going in, trying to go for Jesse, he will get a hit off. Swarm comes out, Jesse still going to be hiding. Ah, gets spotted on the sidelines, will be killed in the meantime. Jesse still going to be hiding in the trees. They're trying to find, they have no idea what the hell he's hiding. We'll finally find him, and Jesse's going to be taken down. Put on a little happy tree, tries to give himself a little bit of space. 100 gold, 1000 gold away from his radiance as well, so it will be a 20 minute ish radiance. We're going to be in trouble. That team will be picked up, and we can get thrown up. Oh man, RP from the Magnus, he goes in, he gets the fling off, he gets the jump off. That's going to be awful, as it looked like the heavy man. That battle tree, you need battle tree, and then you need like 10 minutes of all the farming of people. The Aegis will drop down. Jazz will pick up the Aegis. That's a good thing. That's a really good time for the final pack to see. They can test the Aegis. They pick up the Aegis as well. And I believe, yeah, they got the kill on the Roshan as well. The Magnus will be taken down. That is a nice little pick up for the Axe. He's getting a 1000 kill streak for ending that Magnus's life. He will be picked off now on the Axe. Magnus will drop. He's going to bring away. He will play into the mid lane a little bit further, trying to go for the tanking, but now he's going to be in trouble as Rabi's going to run him down with that Radiant. Combat comes a little bit closer, but oh, not close enough, the Abaddon died! Like, raging inside right now, I imagine. Bottom lane, maybe. That's the ship. He go forward, he sees him, one more hit, it's all he...
Twice the destruction!
Oh wow, Armel is just always up. It's a very, very fast hero now, and that's the only thing that Leon needs to do this game. So I think that's what he's going to hit on Yacht. Gets a nice jump, but the RP comes up, comes up, of happy feet. Tango goes in with the epicenter, with the power strike. The Leon drops down, the axe will fall, and that is going to be 2 dead, potentially 3 dead on the side of happy feet. As RP comes out, the Magnus goes in, Barstrack comes out as well, the Magnus goes in right now, have the hit available, but they don't need to use it. Rapid will just go in, dive a little bit, get that damage up, get the kill on the Axe, get the kill on the Warlock as well, and the Axe is going to be down for 70 seconds. Rax will be taking down the mid lane, and now they're just moving from lane to lane, they want to take everything. Bennett's going to be jumped, Q comes back, he's going to be controlled, he will be killed as well. Bennett's down for 30. In on the different lanes, that will go on the target. The tank will move in. The Warlock will be taken down first. That's going to be a gem on the ground as the tank will happily pick that one up. Rap is going to move in. He's going to run down Ben, and that is going to be maybe Ben a little bit in trouble. Skill comes up, and he's going to be pulled back, and he will be taken down as well. 40 seconds on the sideline. We'll come back to feel a bit in trouble. Yacht will be taken down on the Axe, will come to win, but that is good. Just going to be one by one. They all get picked off. DG gets called as Happy Feet. That's nothing last kill for go and just, you know, be like, I'm fighting now, guys. I'm Antimage, I fight now, and then game, guys. I mean, the draft was not necessarily that bad from the side of Happy Feet. I feel like the anti-mage...
Team pick.
Wonder.
Outworld Devourer.
Okay, okay. You know, good matchup. Oh, the Tangle. Dangerous in the meantime. They are going to be smoked up on side. Off touch gamers. He's baiting a little bit. There's bomb backs here. They run in. They try to set up for something. The Shackles is going to be available on the Shadow Shaman, but they don't find the jungle they were looking for. And that means that bomb backs might be able to stop the tanking. Comes up. Soon Chains is going to be stopping this from happening. The Asphalt will keep the Sanctuary King alive for now, but it's like he's going to be picked off either way. Yarch goes in. And then it looks like there's going to be a little bit of a skirmish coming. The Sanctuary goes in for a bar frag onto that. A couple more hits is going to be enough to do the trick as Armel in the meantime tries to go and Ben tries to get a kill on him. He's dropping down here as that Venomous Gale is going to be enough down. Armel in the meantime might be a little bit in trouble. Bar frag comes on again from the Sanctuary. He will get a double kill. Using Ben this the game already, they want to be very, very aggressive. They have those running, they go in, they set up a jump, they get the Syrian chains off. That's going to be the OD a little bit of trouble. They will be picked off by Solo on the Shadow Shaman, will be taken down as well. As he's going to be the next one dropping down, Ben is going to be a little bit in trouble. He tries to acro switch to the tanking, but that's not going to be happening. Bombax in the meantime might be able to try and find another kill on this guy as he's running him down, but he doesn't have any more mana to be able to go for another jump. So he's going to chase him on the tree lines, but that will only do so much. Is usually a little bit too greedy. But gamers, they'll end up losing a person as a rival. All day, I'll probably get some other people to be able to 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 get some goes and gets a double kill. The Timothy's will at the same time and as the PM drop on the any more mana available. They have another couple of stuns available for the bar strike from on three people. That's a big one. Fling initiation, two kills on the tank. He might lose his own life, but that's still going to be worth it. Setting up for that kill on the OD, killing the support. Kind of like that. Bottom line is that the OD might be able to stop trying to do a little bit of damage on the Ben in the meantime. Probably will be picked off as well as that on the Centaur is going to be a nice upgrade. They're going to see the jewels, that's going to be a nice opening. They go for the top, they get a lot of stuff damage off. Ultimate comes up in the monkey, in the meantime, the jewels are going to be picked off again. In the background, the man opening on that ambush, they get the kill on the Centaur. He's going to be picked off as he tried to dodge it, but it's not going to be happening. Very nice kill, right? The Sivak will be picked off as well in the background, so see jewels. Well, that healing ward is keeping him up and running, but he's going to find another jump and he's going to pick off the but he's not going to be moving anywhere. Oh no, no, no. So I guess maybe he thought that, you know, the fight was already lost and Tinsel was already dead, so it's like level. Demon King the bottom end. The jump on might be able to survive, he's going to jump away, but no. That tank King with his passive, his classic mana popping. The Venomous Gale comes out of all sorts of they are in lost 2 years, they need to get the hell out of there as clutch keepers, they don't want to lose anything more. They possibly can, not having to worry about sustain, not having to worry about taking down as well. That is one, that is two, that is three. As the Sanky will be up to the top lane, continue to push with the team. The T1 dog will be taken down. My clutch game is on the comes up. They go for the ultimate as well. They try to go on Jules. That's been stolen. Ben comes in back with a deep back on the meantime. He can't get the TJP as well. Oh, but no, it bounces right back onto the OD, and the OD will be picked off. Sentai will lose his life as well. The Venomancer will be picked off. This is looking awful. As Happy Feet. Oh, the bounces for that Ominous Slash was beautiful. It bounced away from the OD, but then it bounced right back. And then that is going to be 4 people that are inside of Clutch Games. They're trying to chase for that Monkey King kill as well. So they know he has that gem available. Can they go for kill on him? Can they find him? They're trying to. They go in. They find a jump on him. They hit him. They go in further. Going to not be able to move further. Gets the tree, then jumps away. And very soon, so they don't want to try and delay too much. They want to fight while that is not available. That comes off. They get a kill in the Shadow Shaman in the background for that armor that's being used. Rabbit continues to fight with that ultimate from Bumbox. It's going to be very annoying. A pleasant fight in the distance. go on to the OD gets control of the Ultimate. The Force Nova is doing a lot of damage to the in the meantime, the back line. Timbersaw goes in, tries to go on Armel. Armel is doing a lot of damage. Might be picked off with double check. They get the kill on Timbersaw. Yes, they do. As they stun him, and they stun him again. It looks like that is going to be a 3-for-3 trade-off, so a very, very even trade-off in the end as the Timbersaw wins out the kill of Venomant. Now let's see, DOD might be a little in trouble, gets crossed by DOD, Sandstorm comes out. Oh, that is so painful! So painful, the Sandstorm. Not able to keep that Sanctum safe, will bring away from Gabi, will keep him alive as well. The Monk King is going to be run down. Once get that kill on the Monk King, he's going to jump himself up in trees in a moment. Will survive for now. In the meantime, Jules will be stopped from moving as well. The playing away from the OD. Jules gets Bane, gets spotted. They have the next, they have the checkup. This is going to be Bane. OD dies. I will win the shot. There's this MP gun. I will win the shot. The OD gets 2-man stomp off. Was rapid. They well, Bane, the man. They might actually get the kill on him in the end as the tackle comes out of full, and despite him dying, he actually sets up moving the other way. They see this happening, this MP comes up, they try to go on him, they go in, BKB gets caught by Jules, no stuff gets out on him from the outside, it's going to be used, it's going to do a lot of damage with it, but it's not going to be enough to, BKB will end in a second, BKB gets caught by DOD in the meantime, Rappi might be a bit in trouble, BKB comes up and dies as well, but Jules is going to be taken down on the Juggernaut, they run into Yaj as well, they try to burn him down, the agent is going to be popped on DOD, in the meantime, Yaj might be a bit in trouble though, he's seeing a lot of damage. Stun comes out, Hex comes out on the Ember Swift, the Jolin trying to get another jump on the Ben, but Ben will get himself the reputation, gets back, might be able to cover the ultimate, comes out from the OD, gets a kill on Ben as well, as Ben is not going to be able to run himself. Also walk the hell away from that, and Lincoln's Deer Guard probably needs to get out of there, in the meantime, the Kikri Tower will be taken down, 5 souls pushing out the mid lane, with the Serpent Wolf, and this well, looks like a good one, so the Tank will be taken down, BKB gets popped by Yachty, he's trying to go in, he's trying to do some damage, in the meantime, maybe trying to find a kill on 5 souls, they want to get that Shadow Shaman kill, that sustained the control. The Shadow Shaman is way too annoying. Now Gabi goes in, and he comes out by Soul, will survive as well. Hex comes out on the Timbersaw. The Timbersaw will be picked up dead for 70 seconds. Will buy back immediately. The Tanking goes for a buyback as well. The two sets of racks has already been taken down. And Clutch Gamers, they might still continue going. They're a little bit low on HP on the OD as well as the Shadow Shaman, but might try and go for something. Ben, jump on. As for Tom start, he might go in trouble. Needs to get himself out of there. He will survive for the moment. This is the ultimate available. Looks like Gamers will be picked off here. We'll get the kill on that guy. Then Manta ultimate comes out, and that is going to be the Timbersaw dropping down the floor. Buyback on the Ember Spirit trying to go in. We'll maybe get a kill on the Shadow Shaman, but that is going to be the only thing that happened. And that is going to be what happens when the DOD goes in. But oh, he forced us into a power strike from the Sand King. That will get the kill on the Ember Spirit. Maybe he's still surviving. That Flame God tanking so much of that damage, and he will be able to get a blink away. So, goodbyes. To say that though, the OD buys back out, boots in, gets a jump in, and the Ember Spirit is going to be picked off 120 seconds on the sideline, so the Juggernaut might respawn, but he's going to be the only one alive now with the CM. They go in, CM gets picked off by the Monkey King Ultimate, the Stampede comes out from Rappi, they go in, they're going to jump on the Juggernaut, and he gets picked off right as he respawns. As they just pop everything, they just play around Rappi's, like, you know, just playing with fire, using his pressure shove, using his Stampede as well, and that's going to be the GG probably coming out very, very soon from Happy Feet. As the game is going to be over, there's no one alive. We'll end the game. Refresh up gets caught by OD. GG gets called, and that is the end. Happy Feet, they will admit defeat. Clutch Gamers playing very nice in this game, and they just did it. Very, very good game. Very good performance by Clutch Gamers. It was a very even game this time around. Like, the first game was maybe.